On the screen, we can see an amen breakbeat. This lasts for 1.5 seconds when played at 160 beats per minute, or 40 bars per minute. Whilst playing this drum loop on the turntable, we can alter its pitch by adjusting the speed of a vinyl record's rotation, which I will simulate now. As you can see, when the pitch is reduced, the amount of audio that we hear within one bar of music also decreases. If we half the original pitch, we only hear half of the drum loop. Alternatively, as the pitch is increased, the drum loop finishes before the end of the bar of music, leaving a gap of silence at the end. But what if we want to change the playback speed of the audio without changing its pitch? The introduction of digital sampling technologies allowed musicians to splice drum loops into individual sounds. The playback of those sounds together mimics the drum loop we heard before. Musicians could then assign the individual sounds to different notes on a keyboard. Here we can see that those notes align perfectly with the original spliced audio above. Watch what happens to the duration of each sound as we slow down the tempo. Notice that when the tempo slows down, the individual sounds still start at the same time, but we can see and hear silent gaps between each sound. This can make the individual sounds seem disconnected from each other. Digital time stretching technology has allowed us to solve this problem. At 160 beats per minute, the amen breakbeat at the bottom looks the same as the first drum loop. However, when we change the tempo now, the durations of the individual sounds adjust accordingly. So when the playback speed is halved, we only hear half of the drum loop. However, no matter how we change the playback speed, the pitch always remains the same. Again, as the speed is increased, this leaves a gap of silence at the end. Time stretching therefore ensures that the individual sounds remain connected.